different than all of you. So, like I say, a vibe attracts a tribe. So we are here together, and we're here in Ghana, and I really don't feel as a foreigner in Ghana. I feel really very much at home. Why? So, many things in Ghana reminds me of home, and it's basically inherent to our culture. And so when I met Kim, and she said she was a musician, and she said she sung, I was just breathtaken by her beauty. And I'm talking inner beauty and outer beauty, because everything that she mentioned also comes out of you. So I was like, oh my God, I'm so honored. And some people are like, no, but it shouldn't be the other way around. I was like, no, you are a musician. You are amazing. Musicians are sacred people. In our culture, in our traditional culture of Africa, musicians are often initiates because they go through initiation rites, because they have that special ability to connect the divine principle and basically to bring down the word of God or the word of the creator or the word of the universe into manifestation to whatever they do. Creativity is really almost, I would call it magic, but not in the sense of magic, you know, an understood magic. It's really in a sense of how we are made. We are made as instruments to express the will of God. So musicians are really the people that I look forward to work with, because I have, you know, a particular mission. I was sent by the Bakayi people, first of all, to say, hey, I want to meet my brother from the US, my sister from Cuba, my cousin from Ghana, my mother from Nigeria. I want to unite Africa, but in another way, not so much like in the way the institution are doing it, and it's fine, I applaud them, I think they're doing an amazing job, maybe doing all the paperwork and constitutionally, but it's so remote from who we are sometimes, it's so remote from us. We watch on the news, we see them on TV, we say, oh, okay, they had an African summit and all the presidents and prime ministers and all the representatives went there, and it's fine. They had a good time, they spoke, they had a nice lunch on, and maybe a gala where they showed, they were there, met and interacted. However, the people like me and you who are, we feel disconnected. So I think that as African, I think that it's beautiful that you do to go and meet each other. And it doesn't take that much to just go and meet each other. And the reason why I do that, and I want more people to do that, is because connection is important. As Kim was explaining, when you reinforce somebody else, you help them grow, and you help them ignite that energy of creation that they carry. Same as when you reflect that to another person, you have done the work. So some people are always wondering, oh, well, why are you so approachable? Why are you so easy to hug? And why are you so, why don't you have a bodyguard? And I say, but I need the hug. I need the connection. I mean, it could be a hug or smile.
I need that.
Yeah, it's an exchange. It's an exchange where I recognize you, you recognize me. I recognize your spirit, you recognize me. So because we are recognized, oftentimes we grow from that. Because all we talk about are self-esteem and women power and this and that. In our tradition, this doesn't exist. We don't have these issues. So I encourage artists to go back and learn a lot of the body of knowledge and wisdom our ancestors had, because we have been conditioned because of the history we have gone through to believe that we have really nothing that valuable. Maybe some folklore and some dances, and that's about it. No, that folklore and those dances are really science. So art is science, music is science, design is science, architecture is science, dancing is science. You have to be able to move with the element around you, to work with gravity in a certain magnitude for you to express those movement or for you to express those sounds. Not only that, but you also have the power of words. Could it be in a painting? A painting can express so many things. And so it's time, I really wanna call on the artist and the artist community, and I do work with filmmakers as well, like Rogers Ofime in Nigeria, and Isaac
Kegozi
in Uganda, because I would like to say that we have social transformation to do. We are responsible because we are the custodian of some very ancient and very wise and very potent tradition and knowledge. And we have to sometimes step back and look at ourselves and look at what we've become and what we have to become. When we have a sister from Baltimore, right, coming to say she's Afrocentric, it just, I'm so wow. And here we are, Africans, trying to be Eurocentric or American-centric. What does that mean?